protein purification. The solution extracted from organisms or cells can be processed with a salting out procedure to precipitate proteins and remove other biomolecules. The precipitated proteins can be redissolved into another buffer solution, allowing the solution to pass through a column packed with porous gel beads. Various protein molecules can be further isolated and purified by their different interactions with gel beads. This technique is called column chromatography. There are four main types of column chromatography. They are affinity chromatography, ion exchange chromatography, molecular sieve chromatography, and hydrophobic interaction chromatography. One may determine which type to use and in which sequence based on the purpose of protein purification. Affinity chromatography. Affinity chromatography exploits the difference of affinity between various proteins and the particular ligands linked on the gel beads to isolate a specific protein. Affinity appears when two sterically complementary molecules approach each other, combined with the intermolecular electrostatic forces, hydrogen bonds, van der Waals forces, and hydrophobic interactions to form a tight and specific binding. Common ligands and their binding molecules include antibody and antigen, or cell or virus containing an antigen, biotin and avidin, or strep avidin, enzyme and substrate, or inhibitor or coenzyme, lactin and glycoprotein or sugar, peptide fragment containing hexahistidine tag, and a divalent nickel ion. Protein or nucleic acid and its binding protein, hormone and its receptor, protein A and immunoglobulin G, IgG, and glutathione GSH and glutathione S transferase, GST, etc. When one is used as the ligand, then the other is the target for purification. Manufacturers have immobilized common ligands on gel beads and made them commercially available. We may also purchase activated gel beads and immobilize proper ligands on them to suit our particular purpose. If the molecule of the ligand is small, it is advised to link a long spacer first to avoid steric hindrance during the specific binding. The chromatography column should be cleaned before packing. When packing, add buffer to fill the bottom of the column and be careful not to generate bubbles. Shut the column valve. Transfer the proper amount of gel beads into the column and wait the beads to settle down. Then the column is equilibrated with buffer of twice the total column volume, maintaining the buffer level 1 cm higher than the surface of gel beads. Wait until the pH of the effluent equals that of the influent, which means the column has reached equilibrium. After shutting the column valve, remove the buffer above the gel medium and load the solution of protein mixture. If necessary, stir the gel medium and allow it to settle for 10 to 20 minutes. This will increase the chance of interactions. Open the valve to allow the sample to completely flow into the gel medium and then shut the valve. Connect the column again and the valve is opened. The column is washed with buffer of multiple times the total column volume and the effluent collections commence. Every collection should be the same volume. Now proteins that cannot bind to the ligand will flow out. The absorbance at 280 nanometer, A280, of effluent in each collection tube is measured. A chromatographic profile can be plotted with the A280 on the y-axis and the number of tubes on the x-axis. Finally, change the buffer to be a elution buffer of twice the total column volume to disrupt affinity or compete for ligand bind sites and elute the target protein off the column. The used gel matrix can be equilibrated again with the buffer for future reuse. The methods for disrupting affinity include raising the sodium chloride concentration of elution buffer to increase the ionic strength, thus weaken the intermolecular electrostatic interactions. Adding an organic solvent, such as ethylene glycol, into the elution buffer to decrease the polarity of water and weaken the intermolecular hydrophobic interactions. Adding urea or guanidine hydrochloride into the elution buffer to disturb the hydrogen bonds between molecules and disrupt the binding of molecules. Changing the pH of the elution buffer to affect the charge of molecules. Since alkaline solution tends to cause oxidation of the sulfur-containing amino acids, thus affects protein structure, acid solution is generally used. The eluted protein solution is adjusted back to neutral pH immediately upon completion of elution. The methods for competing ligand binding sites include using molecules structurally similar to the ligand to compete for binding with the protein, using molecules that can bind to the ligand to compete for ligand binding. Affinity chromatography has the following advantages. Protein structure and function are retained. It has high specificity and resolution. It is capable of processing large volume of sample. Because the sample volume of affinity chromatography does not affect its resolution, when used as an early step of protein purification, it can quickly yield a small volume of the target protein in high concentration. About the application of affinity chromatography, a hexahistidine tag may be attached to the N or C terminus of an expressed protein using genetic recombination technique. And the aminodiacetic acid, IDA, or nitrilotriacetic acid, NTA, gel beads with bivalent nickel ion affinity can be used for column chromatography. Imidazole, which has a structure similar to histidine, can then be used to compete for the nickel ion binding sites and purify the expressed protein. Similarly, attach a specific enzyme such as GST to the N or C terminus of the expressed protein. Then this expressed protein can be purified by the column chromatography using the substrate GSH as ligand. HisTag has small molecular size, thus exerts little effect on the folding of protein molecules, whereas GST has large molecular size, thus can strongly affect the folding of protein molecules. However, linked GST can increase solubility and decrease toxicity of the expressed protein. Whether the GST molecule should be cleaved away with protease depends on the need of subsequent experiments.